What's up and welcome back. I'm John Stark from MacMovieGuy.com. This is spooky season. It's a flashlight. I'm doing this time around. This is in a violent nature. It's not spooky. But we're going to talk about it anyway because a lot of people think it is. So, this is, I got this with audio description out of the Apple Store. It's currently on AMC Plus where it lives without audio description because AMC Plus, for some reason, makes audio description for things that they don't put on their own streaming service and then they send it out for literally, like, baffling. The Apple Store will let you know, like, if you subscribe to something, it's like play. And then so when I went there, I had to, like, go all the way down to rent down at the bottom because it's like, well, it's on a streaming service. So you don't have to pay for this. You can click play. But it also clearly states not with audio description. So, but it does in the Apple Store have audio description. Anyway. It's done by Micah Grossman of Audio Eyes. This is terrible audio description. Thank you, Micah, for writing really inadequate audio description. One of my least favorite tracks of the year. And actually, I'm not the first person. That's probably one of the reasons I was a little... I didn't really want to see this film because it seemed like it was just what like existed for gore. Like, and no other reason. But I've heard from probably two or three other people who have seen this film that this was an audio description track that they really did not like. I'm going to put that mildly because I don't want to speak for them. I'm sure they all have very specific reasons, but very underwhelmed. Everybody's been underwhelmed. Nobody likes this track. Congratulations. You've written a track nobody likes. Why? Well, because it's a horror movie, dude. First of all, this is a horror movie where I've heard from pretty much everybody that it is gory as shit. Just like the whole point of this film is violence and gore. I would disagree and say that there's no point to this movie, but we'll get into the movie part in a minute. There's one scene where it was like moderately, but because there was no way to describe it at all without describing the gore, and it's the yoga kill, I would say that's the best way. I'm going to try to avoid as many spoilers as possible, but it's really hard to talk about this film. Plus, this film is stupid, and you won't care about any of the characters anyway. This is one of those films where like everybody's poorly written. There's no reason for anybody to be anywhere. It's like impossible to even know who anybody is, like discernibly different from somebody else. I don't even know who's dating anybody. Like their relationships to each other just make no sense. Basically, everybody just seems like they were transplanted into the woods to die. I felt like I was playing like Friday the 13th, the video game, but like nobody was playing the human characters and you're just Jason. And like, you're just like floating through the map and all the humans are just kind of like wandering around. They're not even trying to complete the tasks. For anybody who played the Friday the 13th video game, it was out before I went blind. I know. You're like, blind kids talking about Friday. Yes, the game's old enough. I played it before I lost my vision. Kind of felt like that. Just like if I was just Jason and everybody else was just kind of like walking around like, what? Huh? So... the film starts off with, I don't know, the dumbass people doing dumbass things, and they take this necklace that they find, which apparently, when that happens, causes this dude to be revived from the dead, and he crawls out of the ground after being buried in this accident, which we learn about later through exposition, because this film is either killing people or it's giving you exposition. Those are the only two things it does. Or walking through the woods. Lots of walking through the woods. My God. This is like fucking Smokey the Bear, the movie. Johnny comes out of the ground, undead person. He goes, kills his first person. Still looking for the necklace. His whole plot is giving my necklace back, you know? It somewhat ties into the end, but then again, I don't know. The ending is terrible. But if you want to peace out, when she gets into the car at the end, you can peace out. Nothing happens after that. It's just exposition. It's really lots of exposition. He wanders around the woods a lot. There was one time where he had, like, he carries an axe, but then he had, like, two hooks. I was like, where the fuck is the axe? You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes he would just, like, his weapon would disappear and then reappear. And it felt like, I was like, am I in a video game? Like, where? You know, like when you're in a video game and you have like that, you know, that cartoonish backpack full of weapons that you can't really see, but you can technically pull out all of these different guns and swords and everything. And you're like, where are these coming from? I felt like this guy was like that, where he's like, I've got two hooks. Now I have an axe. I'm like, where the, you can't, is the axe strapped to your back or something? Like, where's, did you put it down? Like, and you were pretty sure nobody else would pick it up? Like, do you have a hiding spot? Like, I was, this film is hot ass. But yeah, there's a group of teens doing nothing, virtually nothing in the woods. They're getting high. If they're having sex, it's not mentioned. They're just doing dumb shit in the woods, for no discernible reason whatsoever. They're just there camping. And none of them have any personality. I don't even know who the lead of this film is. None of them can act. It's just like the director of this film found his friends and were like, I'm going to make a movie. Do you want to come with me? And they were like, well, we're not doing anything else. I have work today, but I can call off. You know, I'm just like, it felt so shitty. I hate all of these actors and I hope none of them ever work again. Nobody in here was good. Nobody in here read dialogue well. Nobody in here reacted to a being stalked by a killer well. The writer of this film is terrible. The director of this film is terrible. One of the worst films of the year. There's a scene where it's actually a much funnier film than it is a scarier film, which says a lot because it's not supposed to be. But there are scenes where I found it to be funnier than scarier. There's a scene where they're like driving around like dumbasses in this car and they're like calling out for their friend. They're like, Terry! I can't remember which friend. It's Tony! I don't know. Fucking whoever. That doesn't even matter what their names are. And I was like, just fucking leave, man. You already know that there's this creepy dude walking around killing your friends. Like, go get help. Go drive. Like, you will be best suited if you go drive, find somebody, and bring back people who have weapons. There is like a ranger guy that comes into this towards the end, and I was like, thank God. I was like, this guy's probably gonna die, but thank God somebody intelligent showed up. His favorite character in the movie was the ranger, because he's like, I know what you did back in the day, and you're not gonna do it again. And I was like, oh my God, this guy's awesome. But he had shades of sort of like the similar characters who have popped up in movies before that are like this, that like they seem like they're badass and they're ready to fight, but really they're gonna die, you know. You're like, this character's sadly of course gonna be overpowered by, but he seemed ready, and I appreciated that. I was like, well, at least this guy's gonna try something here. I don't know, there's a scene where he's walking through the firehouse and he's trying to get back his gear, Johnny, the undead killer of this movie, and he throws this body into this case. That's the best way. He's carrying around like a body and a decapitated head. I don't know. I also don't know where he got the saw. I don't know where he does anything. Most of the stuff in here, just large question marks. He does walk through the woods a lot. This film is so slow. It is so poorly paced. When I say 30 minutes could be cut from this film, I truly believe it. I believe 30 minutes could be cut from this film, because there's never anything interesting that happens in any conversation anyway. So if you're not going to give exposition, why even bother to establish them as characters? Like, it's just them mumbling. The mic isn't even on them well enough. Like, they're not even mic'd well enough to be able to understand what they're saying. So I don't even understand what the point of the whole thing is. So just go ahead and get rid of that. Get rid of the whole thing. Just have him walking through the woods killing random bodies. I think a lot of this, I've heard at least some of this is shot from like first person perspective. You would never know from the audio description if that's true. Make it that. Make it like Hardcore Henry, but for like serial killers. You know what I'm saying? Like, do that instead, because this does not work. The final scene, the car ride from hell, where I was like, well, maybe something will come at the end of this. Nothing came at the end of that. Nothing happens at the end of that. It just, the car ride kind of ends. Maybe something is suggested because of the exposition that we just got, but nothing actually happens. the movie just fucking ends. So, yeah, I hate this movie, but, and I Micah Grossman's audio description is desperately underwhelming. There are large scenes where nothing's happening because there's no score. There's barely any dialogue. Johnny doesn't speak. And he's in arguably the most of the movie is Johnny. So most of the movie is just him walking around really fucking slowly too. This is talk about Michael Myers could outrun this dude. You know, this is this guy. There was a scene where we were in the woods with them talking, with the gang talking for a long period of time. And it went on forever. And I was like, is he ever going to jump out? Is anything going to happen? And like, finally, like one guy gets up and leaves and goes back into the woods. And I was like, oh, thank God. Like, this film is one of the slowest horror movies I've ever seen. Anybody who likes this film, I question your taste. I'm mostly of a, well, you know, to each their own. I appreciate your value and your opinion. I'm glad that you liked it, that kind of thing. I really don't. There are gorier films that have better pacing. There are gorier films that have characters. There are gorier films that have more interesting villains. There are gorier films that are better directed. I don't there are gorier films with scores. Like, I don't get what you see here at all. And it could be the blindness in the audio description, but again, there are gorier films. It can't just be the gore. There have to be, because there are other films out there that have gore, and then it can't just be that. It's not like this is the one film where you're like, oh, well, finally. I've lived my whole life watching Disney cartoons and I finally get to see something. That just can't be it. Yes, Yoga Girl got gnarly shit happened to her. But most of the time, this audio description avoids describing as much of the blood and gore as possible. And just does like simple, like character decapitated, you know. That kind of thing. Or there's an arm over there. You know what I'm saying? Like that kind of thing. Like it's just whatever. It doesn't feel like a gory movie at all. When you listen to the audio description of the film, you're like, even that scene with the yoga girl is underdescribed because it's just trying to like tell you what's happening, but it's trying to do it in like the least gory way possible. It just sounds gnarly. So, yeah. I would never recommend this. I wouldn't recommend this to people I don't like. I recommend this to nobody. But it is spooky. It's part of spooky season. I'm holding it for spooky season. Seeing this before October and sitting on it. So when you watch this, it'll be sometime in October. And you'll be like, well, I'm looking for scary movies. This is not it. These are not the droids you're looking for. I'm going to give In a Violent Nature a D-. In a year that has given us Tarot, The Strangers Chapter 1, The Deliverance, Night Swim, and some other just truly shitty movies, this one is one of them. And it's a shame because Shudder has actually knocked a couple way out of the park. Late Night with the Devil and Oddity are fantastic, if nothing else. It might be two of my favorite horror films of the year. Right there. So they didn't need this. This is unacceptable and it's really bad. So thank you for watching. Thanks for subscribing and I'll see you guys on the other side.